Welcome to the Fortress of Nerditude. Today, I will be reviewing DC Collectible Designer Series, Darwin Cook, Batman. Darwin Cook's Batman, sculpted by Jonathan Matthews, and is a great representation of Cook's artwork. Darwin Cook's art style is taking iconic characters of the DC Universe and bringing inspiration from the Golden and Silver Age of comics. In 2004, Darwin created a story called The New Frontier about the change from the Golden Age of comics to the crazy, out there stories of the Silver Age. In that story, he had a subplot about Batman. Darwin looked at those classic stories and wanted to create a narrative about why Batman changed his costume from being black and gray of the night to blue and gray Avenger of Justice. In that story, Batman is saving a kid from a cult who was going to sacrifice him. Batman jumps into the room and beats up the goons, and then goes to untie the kid. But the kid was scared of Batman. Later on in the story, Superman goes into the Batcave and sees Robin working on the Batmobile and Batman on the Batcomputer. Superman sees that Batman changed his costume and asks why he changed it. Batman says, "Let me just say I'm out to scare criminals, not children."
Fair enough.
The best thing about this figure is sculpt, because DC Collectibles and its previous name, DC Direct, are all about the sculpt. Taking a 2D image and making it three-dimensional. The paint is another great thing about this Batman. I love how they keep the cowl, the cape, the bodysuit, and the underoos matte. But the gloves, the boots are shiny, and the logo. I love how they make it look like the parts that are matte look like cloth, and the parts that are shiny look like rubber. The only thing that isn't that great on this figure is the belt, because yellow is a very hard color to apply to figures. If you look at it closely, let me see if I can clear it up. The top of it, you can see black coming through. Also the same on the bottom, you can see the black coming through. That for me doesn't really destroy the figure, but it's there, I have to address it. Let's check out the face. The face is one of the greatest things about this figure. I love the ears, the way they look. Pointy, the way they look slightly bent to make them look even more Golden Age than every other figure in my collection. I love the eyes, how sharp they look. They look like they're ready to strike terror in the hearts of criminal scum. And the mouth, the way it stands out can be seen from miles away. Even the skin tone works. Let's check out the cape. The cape is a lightweight rubber-like plastic that lays on the figure beautifully. With the great folds in it, it looks beautiful. Even the large fins make him look badass. The articulation is he's got a rotation in the head. Head can go left and right. Can go slightly up and bury its chin into its neck. He's got pivot points that go left and right to give attitude. Arms are on a pivot joint. They can go out horizontally to the body. Bend in the elbow, rotation in the glove. Waist twist, legs go forward and back. And a bend in the knee. There you go. Here is DC Collectibles Darwin Cook Batman, which is a great 3D version of his 2D art. If you would like to grab your own, please go to the link on the screen now. Also will be in the description of the video. Thank you for watching, and if you liked this video, could you please subscribe and give a like? More is on the way from the Fortress of Nerditude.